least 9 of Mueller's 17 attorneys are Democratic donors, 5 of them donating to Hillary Clinton, not a single Republican among them. And our first guest tonight says the public trust is gone after Rosenstein's appearance today before his committee. He's calling for a second special counsel. And joining us tonight is Congressman Jim Jordan. He serves on both the Judiciary and Oversight Committees, a member of the House Freedom Caucus. And Congressman, great to have you with us.
Good to be with you.
Rod Rosenstein, today I've been wanting to ask the question since he began talking of you, is, what was your reaction when you heard him dismiss everything?
Well, look, you can't make this stuff up. This story gets worse and worse each and every day. And the email that Catherine highlighted in the earlier segment, the text message, she picked the right message because the anti-Trump text, that's no big deal. I mean, we know everyone on the Mueller team is anti-Trump. You just went through the whole list. But the text message where he says to Lisa Page, Peter Strzok says to Lisa Page, we can't let this happen. In other words, we can't let Donald Trump be president. That shows that he's thinking about a plan to stop one party's nominee from being president. And remember Peter Strzok. He's the guy who ran the Clinton investigation, interviewed Cheryl Mills, interviewed Secretary Clinton. He's the guy who took the exoneration letter and changed the term gross negligence, which is a crime, to extreme carelessness, which is not a crime. He's the guy who ran the Russian investigation. He's the guy who interviewed Flynn. He's picked by Mueller to be on his team and kicked off for these text messages. Right. I think he's the central player here. And now we have this text message between him and Lisa Page where he says, we need a plan. He even says this, Lou. He says, we need an insurance policy in case the American people, in his mind, are crazy enough to elect Donald Trump. We need something else to stop Trump. That's what this guy was thinking at the highest levels of the deputy head of counterintelligence at the FBI. That's what this is about, and that's why we need a second special counsel and should disband the whole Mueller team right now.
The Robert Mueller, the special counsel, and Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein, the effective head of the Justice Department, now. Let's just put up the quote from Peter Strzok again so everybody sees it and understands. And this is the quote you focused on immediately. Because you were not appalled by just simply the anti-Trump part.
No, everyone knows.
You were appalled by the fact this was an active effort to prevent his path to the presidency.
It shows intent, Lou. It shows intent to do something to stop Donald Trump, who was nominated by the Republican Party running for president. It shows they're trying to stop him, and it all has to do, I believe, with this dossier.
And let's read it. I want to believe the path you threw out for consideration in Andy's office, presumed to be Andrew McCabe, the number two person at the FBI, that there's no way he gets elected. But I'm afraid we can't take that risk. It's like an insurance policy in the unlikely event. You die before you're 40. This is, as you say, clearly intent. It also is presumptive of some illusion that takes him, I think, even beyond what you were suggesting about James Bond and the FBI. This is a man who's a political activist who means to have his way, which is the only way. It's anti-democratic, it's anti-American, it is god-awful. And yet, Mueller doesn't call for his resignation, yet Rod Rosenstein doesn't call for his resignation.
Yeah, he wants to wait on
an inspector general. Does anybody make a decision in the Department of Justice?
Yeah, no kidding. And this is bad. And here's the concern. Peter Strzok thought he was saving the world. He's Mr. Super Agent James Bond in his mind. He thinks he's out there doing this wonderful service by going against the very guy that people are going to elect, President Trump. He is no different. And this is scary. He's no different than Lois Lerner, who thought she had to go after conservatives because they're having too much influence in politics. It's the exact same mindset. But here we have the guy who I think took the dossier, the discredited, disproven dossier, fake news, garbage dossier, took that document that the Clintons paid for, took that dossier, I think he dressed it all up and presented it to the FISA court. I think the deputy head of counterintelligence, Peter Strzok, did that. And if that happened, when you boil this all down, Lou, it's really about two questions. Did they pay Christopher Steele? Did the FBI pay him? It's been reported they did, the guy who wrote the dossier. Right. And did they take his work product, the dossier, and present it as real intelligence and take it to the FISA court to get warrants to spy on people associated with Trump's campaign? If the answer to those questions is yes, then this is as bad as anything I've ever seen in government. And if the answer is yes, people like Peter Strzok need to be held accountable.
By accountable, do you mean go to jail?
If that's where it takes us, but we don't know that until they give us the information. We haven't even, we need to depose Peter Strzok. We need him sitting right where Rod Rosenstein sat today, answering our questions in front of the whole world. We need Andrew McCabe. We need Lisa Page. We need this guy, Bruce Orr, who you brought up earlier. We need all these people to come in. We're going to depose them. We're going to get the documents, and then we're going to put them on the stand and have them answer questions. We'll see if they take the fifth, or we'll see if they answer questions.
You know, I would love to see a grand jury impaneled here. I'm really very tired of political accountability that ends up in two or three paragraphs, sometimes a half a page of reporting. I much prefer to see jail sentences for violating the trust of the American people and working against the Constitution and, yes, the President of the United States.
You're tired of it, Lou, and most importantly, I'm tired. I'm tired of it. But most importantly, the American people are tired of it. They're sick of the double standards. Because you're Peter Strzok, some big shot at the FBI, there's a different standard for you than the folks I get the privilege of representing in the 4th District of Ohio. It is not supposed to work that way.
Yeah, let me ask you this, because as I listened, and you've been asking these questions for a long time, and I'm always interested at this. The quiet chill that seems to be the only answer these officials are capable of when you ask, did you pay for the dossier? Did you think about the consequences of what you're doing? And they don't answer, but their silence and the chill in the air is an answer of its own. And I don't think it's going to be very pleasant for the American people when we get the answers.
Yeah, I'm afraid the answer to those questions is yes, which actually deep down scares me. If this actually happened, the FBI had a concerted effort with people at the top to go after one party's nominee to help the other party's nominee. If that actually happened in the United States of America, and everything each and every day points to more and more likely that that is what took place, that is just, it's sad for our country if that in fact took place. And I think it did, based on everything I'm seeing, all the evidence points to that.
Congressman Jim Jordan. As always, a terrific job today in committee, and thank you for being with us here tonight.
Thank you.
We're coming right back.